Thanks for joining us here on the web. I'm Adam Sexton, and here's a look at the stories we're following this afternoon. A car sale in the Queen City goes wrong. Two men facing charges accused of robbing a couple that sold them a car they weren't happy with. The two suspects are accused of pointing a gun at the victims, stealing cash before taking the vehicle they were supposed to return. WMUR's Ray Brewer has the story.
Christopher Core told the court he wasn't clear on the four charges against him. Those charges include armed robbery, being a felon in possession of a dangerous weapon, and two drug charges.
He ultimately was found in possession of packaged cocaine in our booking department.
Back on February 29th, police say that Core and another man entered a Manchester apartment on Bodwell Road. That other man that was involved, according to police, was Joseph Alston. He was arraigned on three charges, including conspiracy, criminal threatening, and theft by unauthorized taking.
They walked into the man's house armed with a handgun, stole the cash that they had paid him for the car, kept the vehicle, and then they left.
Yesterday, police say the victim spotted the two men sitting in the parking lot of the apartment complex. The victims called police and followed the men to a gas station where police arrested the two. Police say that this all began as an online transaction and that there is a lesson to be learned. Always find a safe place to do the transaction, never at your house.
In a case like this where the deal did not work out, these people came back not only that night, but a week later.
Today, the U.S. Senate approved a bill addressing heroin addiction and prescription painkiller abuse. The Comprehensive Addiction and Recovery Act expands communities' access to critical tools needed to battle painkiller abuse. That includes establishing federal grants for state and local governments to use for treatment and prevention programs. It also increases the availability of drugs used to combat overdoses. The measure got final approval, as we noted, today. Happening now, testimony continues in the case of a former Rochester paramedic accused of diverting drugs meant for hospital patients. 50-year-old Donald Penny is accused of withdrawing the opiate painkillers fentanyl and hydromorphone from a dispensing machine inside Frisbee Memorial Hospital without doctor's orders. Prosecutors call this a case about addiction. Penny is facing 29 separate charges. New details in the Jerry DeLimas case. He will be remaining here in New Hampshire. DeLimas was granted a stay order stopping his transfer to Nevada. The order will give more time to review the decision that was keeping him detained, and it says he will be able to hire a lawyer to appeal the detainment order. DeLimas is charged in connection with the armed standoff in the Bundy Ranch in Nevada in 2014. Right now, a Raymond man is in a Boston hospital after he was burned in a house fire. That fire broke out around 9 last night on Agent Drive. Raymond's fire chief says four adults and a dog were inside at the time. All of them made it out, but officials say one man suffered burns to his head, face, and throat while apparently trying to put out those flames. Starting tonight at 5, the debate heating up right now at the State House over taking kids away from parents who are known heroin users. And the activist arrested in connection with the Bundy Ranch protest will not be extradited just yet. That does it for us here on the web. I'm Adam Sexton. Have a great afternoon.